Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Survival with me, AvaGamer. What better way to celebrate Halloween and the spooky season with some of Minecraft's mobs and how to take advantage of them? So today we're going to be talking about three different XP mob farms that I've been working on and will be using in this world. So be sure to hit that like button if you enjoy this demonstration, and also consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't yet. And now that we're back out of the end, we do have this nice little dragon egg too that we'll eventually be putting in a better place, but we're gonna be using this stuff that I've got in my ender chest here to put together the last XP farm at the end of the video. I did make two other XP farms before the 50 subscriber special in episode 10. These will just be basic details, so if you're looking for more in-depth designs for the farms, links will be in the description. This first one's in the Nether, so let's hop on over there. So this first one involves zombie pigmen, but it's not super difficult to make. There are some pretty big builds out there to create these insane gold farms, but this is just a simple XP farm. First, what you need to do is carve out a little hole in a hillside where you can hunker down while all of the piggies are aggroed to you. You don't need it to be super large, but you do need enough room to hide out in. The next thing that you need is a pit that the zombie piglins can fall into. It needs to be about 3 blocks deep and 2 blocks across. You can make it as wide as you need to, but it doesn't need to be super wide. After that, you need some trapdoors. Most mobs think that they can walk over trapdoors without falling into a gap, so what you're just going to do is place a couple down and make sure that they think they can get to you if the trapdoors were open. Or if the trapdoors were closed, that is. And then if they're open, they won't be able to get to you. Simple enough. And they'll just kind of fall down there, and what you'll need to do is build a little bit of a access tunnel for your killing chamber. What I did here is I dug down right to the pit and made sure that there was a hole that they could get into, that I could get to them with. And finally, the next thing is that you need them all to come over here. This is the fun part though. It's best to be at full health and find a good piggy and attack it. As an afterthought, though, it probably would have been better to use a bow and arrow while I stayed in my little hidey hole. Instead, I just kind of enderpearled over, found a good one that I could run away from without getting surrounded, and then enderpearled back into the farm. So you'll see how that worked out here with this guy. It's like playing Ring Around the Rosie. Really dangerous game of Ring Around the Rosie. But as you can see, they all just kind of funnel in, and you can take them out one by one. There are a few drawbacks to this. If you want the loot, you have to add a door to get in and out, as well as make sure that there aren't any zombie piglins in there. Otherwise, some bad things can happen. Okay, now that you've seen a simple nether mob grinder, it's easy to make, but it can be pretty dangerous to run though. So now it's time to try the next one. This one requires a bit more prep work than the last one does, but it does provide a constant source of XP as well as mob parts that depend on what kind of mob you employ. What I'm talking about is a zombie spawner, in this case. Any old spawner would do. I prefer skeleton ones though, but this one will have to do for now. So here's how the farm building went, and eventually I will put up a good build up here on this top of the hill, but our access point is just down at the bottom of it, so let's check that out. First, what you want to do is make easy access to your mob spawner. Closer to the surface is better for other things, but you're going to want to clear the area for a 9x9 space with a couple of blocks for the floor and for the ceiling. Make sure that you light it up though as you're building, otherwise you can have things like this guy appear on you while you're trying to clear things out. So next we're going to dig a little channel over on one side of your 9x9 area that needs to be at least 2 blocks deep and goes off to a water elevator that I'm going to put over in that corner over there. The channel needs to take them to a place that's less than 16 blocks from the spawner. That's how far mobs can spawn from you. The water elevator is going to drop zombies down, in this case, or skeletons, 22 or 23 blocks down, so that means they're only one shot from death. So, made sure that our tunnel links up, and the final steps are to make sure that there aren't any holes for zombies to get out, and to make a water source along the whole back. That way, pushes all of the mobs into your channel. And then the final thing is to turn out the lights. Once all the lights are out, you should have the spawner making a constant source of enemies that will get pushed into your killing chamber, and you'll have a nice steady source of zombies or skeletons or whatever that you can use to get all that good XP and mob parts. Another thing to note is that you want to make sure that no babies can access you. I mean, baby zombies are one of those things that are not very pleasant to deal with. Okay, those two were nice, but they weren't super efficient. There is one thing that we can make a super efficient farm with. Plus, the first one was pretty dangerous. For the best XP farm we can make, we have to head back to the end. So, back to the stronghold, and let's head down into that end portal. And head off to the main island, where we can create a pretty good spawner. Okay, so here's what I have in mind. We need to build a bridge, basically to the middle of nowhere, and we are going to be building an Enderman farm. Endermen are the only natural spawning mobs out here, so we can use that those spawning mechanics for Endermen to our advantage to create kind of an ideal farm. And that's what we're going to be building. I'm going to start off at the bottom here of our main end island and bridge out 150 blocks or so into the void. The reason that we're doing that is to make sure that nothing else is within our spawning radius while we're out there. Okay, this is the dangerous part of the build, though. You have to make sure that you have elytra before this, otherwise it can get quite dangerous. I'm using slabs to make sure that no mobs spawn naturally on the slabs, and here we go. This one is my least favorite part. Always spooky and scary out here in the end. Okay, so now that we're all the way out here from our main end island, you gotta build a little area that you can stand on, a platform that will allow us to kind of be in a safe spot as well as attack all the mobs. I did not mean to place that there. Let's go for there and get rid of that. And build our little safe platform. Okay, so I got our safe platform here. The next thing that we're going to need to do is start with some chests and hoppers that will catch all the ender pearls when we kill all the endermen. So I'm going to have a 3x2 area for them to drop onto with a platform that I can attack them all right here and not get hurt. So the next step is to build up 42 or 43 blocks above these hoppers. That'll make them all one hit from death. So let's cue that time lapse. Thank you. Alright, I added water at the bottom so the Endermen don't spawn or teleport out of this chamber that I'm building. But now comes the most difficult part. Endermen do not like a creature called Endermites that sometimes appear when you throw enderpearls. So we're going to be putting one in a minecart here, if I can get one. Maybe. There it is. Okay, now I gotta get out of here and get it in this minecart here. Come on. There we go, perfect. Next step is to name tag it, and then now it won't disappear. Okay, I had to break the name the minecart for it to actually get name tagged. But now it's called the Mighty Bug, and we're gonna put it back in the minecart here. Please. As long as it doesn't kill me. Ow. Okay, let's get out of here. I don't want to die. Okay. That was fun. And it's... Ow. I think it was in the minecart. We'll jump back up there. Okay. So, now that it's in the minecart, the next thing we need to do is to build a platform all the way around here. That the Enderman will spawn on. We're going to use a 33 by 33 block area, and that will allow a really good number of Endermen to spawn out here, and we will not have any problems collecting all the XP that we need. Alright, it's all finished. So as you can see here, once we turn around, there are Endermen just kind of raining down into here. And it's really loud in here, so now we can just heal up all of our mending gear super easy. And we'll have a ton of Ender Pearls, and yeah, it's pretty great. So now that I've got all of these Endermen dying in front of us, we are just going to be skyrocketing in levels, really. This is one of the best XP farms that you can make. Super constant source, and you'll never really run out of levels. I mean, look at that. I'm already about 51. So, if you have enjoyed these XP demos, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe if you haven't yet. Before signing off, though, I do need to fix one thing out here. All the XP is getting caught in the hoppers, so maybe some slabs ought to do the trick. But we could basically throw out all our good stuff and restart, just like this. Okay, I really wanted to keep my elytra. Hey guys, quick note here. I just wanted to say thank you for all the support that you've given. I'm super glad that we were able to make it to 50 subscribers and beyond. But I'm hoping that we can get to 100 by the end of the year. Seeing that it's almost Halloween though, I need your help. I've got some big plans for the rest of the year, including more challenge videos. So make sure that you share this channel with others and see if we can get to 100 subscribers soon. Also, if you have any Halloween-themed build ideas, I'd love to hear them, and we'll get to my favorite one next week. Until next time, though, take care and ciao.